Joy to the world. Merry Christmas. Warm welcome to each and every one of you. This Christmas Eve, it is good to be together in God's house. Know that no matter who you are or where you are on life or faith's journey, know that you are welcome here. All of you welcome to hear God's word. All of you welcome the Lord's table for Holy Communion. For this is Christ's church, and Christ welcomes all people, no exceptions. Just one preparatory note for this evening's service. Everything for the service is in your worship bulletin, so you want to make sure you have one of those. The ushers would be happy to get you one of those. You will need a candle for Silent Night, so if you didn't get one of those, pick that up. And you have come to the very fun 5 o'clock all-in pageant service. And by all-in, we mean everybody, all ages. This is not a child-only experience. Anyone can participate. So if by chance you didn't manage to pick up a halo or a shepherd's hat or a donkey ears, whatever it is you'd like to be, fear not, there's still some time. During the opening, you know, a few hymns, just slip to the back, make a selection or multiple. Last year, I think Sydney was every role of the pageant. So if you are that versatile of an actor, feel free. But do come forward, as it says in your bulletin, when it is time. With that, let us worship our Jesus, our newborn King, the Savior of the whole world. Oh, come, let us adore him.
Thank you.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders. And he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem. Because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to be delivered of a child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you.
Now in that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and laying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace to all people on earth." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, They made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. This is the Christmas story. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
But before we dismiss you all, I need to make sure we know who all is here. So hold on, bells. Just give me a second. You're so prompt. We need this beautiful tableau. So who all's here? Let's see. Let's go reverse order. Where are my shepherds? Are you shepherding? Did you find some sheep? Find a sheep. You need a shepherd. They're all over. They've wandered away. All right, we've got shepherds. We have sheep. What do the sheep make? What's the noise they make? Bah! Let's see. Who else have we got? We've got some donkeys. What do they make? Hee-haw. Hee-haw, right? We've got some cows. What noise does the cow make? Moo. Let's see. Oh, we got a goat. I don't know. What noise does the goat make? Kind of a bah. Any other? Did anybody take the camel? I don't know what a camel makes. It kind of spits, doesn't it? We have a horse. Nay. All right, good. So we got a whole barnyard of animals. We got our shepherds. We have our angels. Oh. Now, what do you think the angels sound like? Maybe the choir can even help you. Right? Oh, so beautiful. So you all are just gorgeous. You're all going to join the choir. Now, who do we have last? Oh, we can't forget Joseph and Mary. These poor parents, they've come from a long way to get here. They had to travel to get here. And poor Mary had to have a baby in a barn. Can you believe it? And of course, the most important person, who's the most important person in the whole Christmas story? Baby Jesus. Baby Jesus, because he was born this night. God's son was born for you and for me to show us how much God loves us. That's the reason we gather in church and we sing these carols and even we do some silly things. Because God did a silly thing in sending us Jesus. Because he said, that's how much I love you. I'll do even crazy things. So you sometimes have to do crazy things to help others and show the whole world that there really is hope. There really is love. There really is peace. Okay? All right. You can go back to your seats, but can we thank them for this beautiful pageant? mercy and peace to you, dear church, this Christmas Eve. Amen. We hear a story oh so familiar, and yet each year we're called to hear it with new ears, new eyes, and open hearts. The story of our Savior's birth. It's the story of a family who've been displaced. They're travelers. They're not at home because of the political regime. They've been asked to move to a new place. They're in Bethlehem, and in fact, there's so many people there, there's no room for them. The only place that this young couple can find to take refuge is in a barn, amongst the animals. This young girl, the Virgin Mary, has to give birth amongst the oxen and the cattle, the sheep. And something tells me they've not had their Christmas baths. It probably stinks. It's not very comfortable. And yet that is where the Mother of God gives birth. It says there's no place for the baby, and they have to lay him literally in the food trough, in the manger. That word manger, it sort of sounds nice to us now, but really that's what it is. It's the feed trough, where the animals go and get their dinner. She lays him there. There's no pomp and circumstance. There's no cuddly new sheets and sweet crib like we would have for our babies. It's a rough story. It's a hard story. It's a story of a poor family, a family on the move. I think many of us in hearing it would, of course, say, why did no one make room for them? Why didn't anybody help them? Well, if we were to ask that, we would not be the first to have asked this. In fact, I was reading this week in preparation one of Martin Luther's Christmas Eve sermons. So this is circa 500 years old when he addressed a crowd on a Christmas Eve. He says this excerpt. The inn was full. No one would release a room to this pregnant woman. She had to go to a cow stall and there bring forth the maker of all creatures because nobody would give way. Now, there are many of you in this congregation who think to yourselves, if only I had been there, how quick I would have been to help the baby. I would have washed his linen. How happy I would have been to go with the shepherds and see the Lord lying in the manger. But Luther goes on, so why don't you now? You have Christ in your neighbor. You ought to serve him. For what you do to your neighbor in need, you do to the Lord Christ himself. Now that, in some ways, gives me new ears, new eyes, and new open hearts to this Christmas story. It's not just about meeting a baby 2,000 years ago for which there was no room, and a world who neglected them. In fact, it's about meeting Jesus Christ every day in our world, born anew, amongst the poor, amongst the hurting, amongst those who we have put aside or ostracized or forgotten, amongst the neglected, amongst the mourning and the sick. That's the neighbor in need. That's the refugee or the abused child or the teen pregnancy still this day, that we're called to see Christ and finally make room in that inn, in our hearts, in our lives, to serve our neighbors, to give Christ room in the world. For Christ keeps coming over and over again to us, born this day in the city of Summit, in the city of New Providence and Chatham, born this day to you in New Jersey, is a Savior. You only hear the angels. If you only make room for him, you only welcome your neighbor in need, you welcome Christ himself. The story goes on with the angels announcing to the shepherds, do not be afraid. Whatever you fear, don't be afraid. This is good news, great news, the very best news. God is for you, is with you. Peace on earth, yes, Even now, the message of the angels still comes, even as his homeland is in rubble, that there is hope for peace on earth. May it be so. So let us too be messengers of God's joy and peace for all people. Let us go in heart and mind with the shepherds, even to that manger bed. Let us see Christ and serve Christ in every neighbor in need. For Christ the Savior is born. Alleluia. Alleluia. Amen.
Gathered with all who seek the Christ child, let us pray for the church, the world, and all people in need. Wonderful counselor, on this holy night, your church throughout the world celebrates the word of God being born among us. Endow your church with a zeal for sharing your love with all. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of hosts, the heavens are glad, the earth rejoices, and the trees sing for joy at your coming. Grant us wisdom and strength to care for your whole creation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Prince of Peace, your grace has appeared and brings salvation to all the world, bringing healing to the people and nations divided by violence. Direct the leaders of the nations so that in self-controlled, upright, and godly living, they may work toward peace on earth. Lord, in your mercy. Mighty God of mercy, you come among us as a vulnerable infant. Comfort and protect all in need, the homeless and the hungry, the widow and the orphan, the sick and suffering, the prisoner and the refugee, the lonely and the dejected, the dying and those that mourn. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, in this holy night, Christians the world over celebrate Christ's birth. Open our hearts that he may be born in us today. Lord, in your mercy. Everlasting God, your steadfast love never ends. We remember before you all who have died trusting in the hope of everlasting life. Hold us all in your love. Lord, in your mercy. Into your gracious hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your steadfast mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share a sign of Christ's peace with one another. Dear friends, once again, welcome and Merry, Merry Christmas. It's so good to have you here this night. Know that you are welcome anytime. In fact, we're open every Sunday, 52 weeks out of the year. We would love to have you join us in worship, in education, in music, in fellowship, and in service to our neighbor, both here and far. We are a congregation that believes seriously in worship, in praising God, but also in seriously in rolling up our sleeves and doing the work God has entrusted to us. We serve a God who gives and gives far more than we ask or imagine, and then calls us to be generous with our resources for God's work in the world. Let us now bring our tithes and offerings.
Unto us a son is given.
For unto us a child.
eternity, born into our humanity and lying in the manger. All that we have are gifts of your grace. As the angels sang of your glory, accept what we bring as offerings of praise and thanksgiving. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join that unending hymn. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for the promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophets' hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your son Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, when the supper was ended, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Amen.
remember your word dwelling among us, full of grace and truth. Remember our new birth in his death and resurrection. We look with hope for his coming. Come, Lord Jesus. Holy God, we long for your spirit. Come among us. Bless this meal. May your word take flesh in us. Awaken your people. Fill us with your light. Bring the gift of peace on earth. Come, Holy Spirit. All honor and glory are yours, Holy One of Israel, Word of God incarnate, power of the Most High, one God now and forever. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Behold, the Word is made flesh and dwells among us. Come, let us keep the feast.
Thank you.
the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Let us pray. Great and saving God, your word has come among us in the holy child of Bethlehem. May the light of Christ's grace illumine our hearts and shine in our words and deeds through that same Lord Jesus Christ, our Emmanuel.
Thank you.
receive the blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, remain with you always. Amen.
Flesh and dwells among us.
Thanks be to God.